Hello, Sagittarius, and welcome to your weekly messages from the universe. Sagittarius, we're going to be seeing this week what blessings are coming for you by looking at some tarot cards and also some oracle cards. I want to remind you to have a look at your sun sign, your moon sign, and also your ascendant sign, because by doing so, you get a much fuller and deeper picture about what's going on for you this week. Now, if you don't know where your ascendant sign is or where your moon sign is, I have linked below in the description box a website that you can go in and put in your time of birth, your date of birth, and it will calculate where all the planets are, and then you can know which sign to look for. It's really important, as sometimes I get asked why I recommend looking at all these different signs. It's because your moon sign will give you that understanding about what you are feeling, because our feelings are really important. We could be experiencing amazing things, but if we are feeling depressed, if we're feeling down, then there's that energy of a dampener on all these amazing things that could be happening. So seeing what your moon sign and how it's being affected is really important. Your sun sign is how the world sees you, and your ascendant sign is how you present yourself to the world. When people first meet you, what it is, what energy gets introduced to them. So it's always nice to know how all these signs are doing, because they give you that whole broader picture about what's going on, instead of just looking at your sun sign, which for me, I think, is the least important sign. So again, see what resonates with you and take it from there. So let's have a look at what is going on. Sagittarius, I can see that you have two major arcana cards opening up this reading for us. So really pay attention to the messages of these two cards, because these two cards here are the trump cards of this reading. They hold the weight of this reading, so they are really important. So you are starting off this reading with the major arcana card of the devil. Sagittarius, this card is here to say that there is a situation that you are really overthinking. You are feeling that you don't have power over this situation. You are stuck and you're stuck in your mind. And with this card, it is here inviting you, giving you that opportunity to come out from your mind, so that you can see this situation from a higher perspective, so that you can see the truth of this situation, because this situation has just been going round and round and round and spiraling in your mind. It is driving you insane. Now, the devil card is about self-deception, and this is true, especially when we have thoughts that are just going round in our mind. We're just overthinking, we're overanalyzing, we are not really seeing all the facts that are there. This is a card about denial. This is a card that also speaks about vices and addictions. So maybe as you are seeing yourself spiraling out of control in your mind, you might literally be using alcohol or drugs to numb out the pain that you might be feeling, to numb out and trying and stopping this cycle of overthinking. This card is a card that speaks about, it's an energy of self-imposed limitations, because it's an energy that speaks like you're seeing a situation, and in your mind, you're making this situation bigger and bigger and bigger. Sagittarius, you have been here before, so you completely understand what the divine is saying here. And then in the past, you've made the situation big. And then eventually when you came out and faced the situation, it wasn't even as bad as you thought it was going to be. So there's a similar type of energy at the moment that you are just thinking, wow, I can't. And you're trying to protect yourself. You're trying to, I don't know, run away maybe from this situation. And the divine is really saying that it is time to to come out. And it is time to pause, reflect, come out from your mind, come out from that cycle of overthinking. In your mind is like this cog, this clock that keeps going round and round and round. Sagittarius, I want you to focus on this card and see what messages are coming up for you, because the divine is going to be speaking to you directly. Because this situation, you understand what it is. And for me, I have to go as broad as possible so that as many people can understand the message that is here. So you're being invited here to come out from that cycle, from that noise that is in your mind. And when you do, you're going to bring out some light. And we're seeing you here as the hanged man, being removed from the situation and looking at that situation from a distance. And you're being invited to be in that energy of pause, of surrendering, of not doing anything. Because we are seeing here that there is time. So you need to just give this situation time. Give yourself time to let your emotions calm down. Let your feelings settle. And as you are here, removed from this situation, as you are here, looking at this situation from a different point of view. Life looks different, right, when we are upside down. So you're turning the situation upside down and you're looking at this situation from all different angles. And when you do that, here's what the divine is saying. The divine is saying that I am going to be able to give you light. I am going to be able to give you inspiration so that you can finally see the truth of this situation. You can finally realize that this situation is not as big as it seems, and that this situation, you are very capable of overcoming that situation. We're seeing that from a distance, this situation almost looks like the planet Saturn. And Saturn is all about restrictions. Saturn is all about that malefic planet that doesn't really feel warm. It's a bit cold. It feels mechanic, right? And so perhaps now, as you are seeing that you are being restricted, as you are seeing that you are being put maybe back under quarantines, this is maybe where this stress is coming from. Because Sagittarius, you are that sign that really enjoys being out and about, a sign that enjoys the adventure of life, traveling. And now you are seeing that maybe your travel plans that you had planned for quite a while are not going to be going ahead. Maybe you had a job offer overseas and you're seeing now that that's been restricted, and that is maybe just driving you crazy because you are so excited about this situation. Maybe you work in the airline industry. We're seeing you floating in the clouds here somewhere, and now your company is saying that we're not needing your services anymore. And this is where you've been worried and overthinking and stressing. But the divine is saying, be in this energy of being suspended, of surrender, so that in that moment, in that time, the divine can intercept that situation and give you the resources, the light, the tools that you need so that you can go forward. And go forward you will, Sagittarius, because we are seeing that the next card we have is the Page of Pentacles. Now, just look at that energy of the Page of Pentacles, the energy that sees you taking responsibility of your health, your wealth, your stability. And not only that, you have your loyal guides that walk with you in this life, who are going to be helping you and giving you tips of how you can preserve, how you can store perhaps that wealth, because you maybe are currently worried about where you should put your money, where is it going to be safe. There's this energy of, if you connect to the divine, remember, the divine is literally gonna laser beam some ideas, some solutions to your situation. And your understanding that you have your guides, connect with your guides, especially now in this moment in time. This is the perfect time to really start connecting with your divine, because right now the veil between heaven and earth is really thin. And the more we get closer to Halloween, the 31st of October, the thinner the veil is getting. And this is the perfect time to really start working with your guides, to really start connecting with your ancestors, to really start asking for loyal guides and celestial beings who can really help you so that you can preserve whatever it is that you feel that you are currently losing. Whatever you feel that is currently slipping away, the divine is saying right now, Sagittarius, there is still time. Now, the Page of Pentacles has that energy of excitement. So you getting that divine inspiration, that aha moment, is going to see you, Sagittarius, feeling excited. It's going to see you feeling like, yes, I now know what to do. The Page energy can be that impulsive energy. So be careful not to just rush off and do something drastic straight away, because you understand that currently Mercury is currently retrograde. So this is not the time to be making major life changes just yet. Receive that aha moment and be in that moment of planning, of re-evaluating of your life, of redoing certain things. And then when Mercury goes direct, this will be the time to start moving, hiding, shifting, whatever it is that you need to shift and hide, or whatever it is that you need to take care of. Now, we are going to look at some oracle cards, Sagittarius, to see what the oracle cards have to say. And we're seeing that this card, Sagittarius, is here reassuring you that luck is on your side. Luck is that divine energy. So remember, if you take the time out to connect, then you are going to have this luck that's going to be here protecting you. If you really take the time out to connect with the divine, you're going to see how your dreams and your desires are not all lost as they might be seeming like they are. You're seeing that you're still able to really make new plans, perhaps. And maybe these new plans are going to see you really feeling excited, inspired. So we'll come out of this energy and start seeing life from a higher perspective, connecting with your guides, connecting with the divine, so that they can give you that intuitive knowing of what to do next. The next card we have, Sagittarius, if you're looking for love, this card is here to say that there is a new romantic cycle begins. And for me, if you're not looking for love, this romantic cycle is going to have to do with your pentacles. It's going to have to do with your wealth, your health, and how you can bring balance through your emotions, stopping overthinking. And we're seeing that balance again is important, because Libra is the sign of balance. And here, seeing you as the Hanged Man, see how balanced you are. So there's this energy again that is calling you to really be in this energy of balance, be in this energy of being still, of not doing anything, of not rushing here or there. Just be in the moment for a while. So the next card we have sees you, Sagittarius, being reminded to believe in the impossible. I loved this card. This is the card that just really lifts up the energy and reminds you that all is not lost. Believe in the impossible. And the thing I loved most, Sagittarius, was This card is the blue moon. And what moon do we have on the 31st of October? We have the Hunter's Moon, which is the blue moon in Taurus. Go and look at the video that I made about the Taurus blue moon so that you can understand the energies that are here. But for me, this card is here for you, Sagittarius, to say that you are going to really start seeing things shifting for the positive on the 31st of October. When that Hunter's blue moon is there, you're going to really start seeing your energies lifting. You're going to really start seeing yourself finally releasing yourself from this imprisonment that you have put yourself in. Now, we are going to be looking at the energies that you're working with, Sagittarius, and you are working with the energies of Mars. Amen to that. I love this energy. And the reason, Sagittarius, I am loving this energy is because you really need this energy on your side at the moment. You need this energy on your side to free you, to fight for you, to be that warrior. Mars is the warrior god. Mars is that soldier, that fighter. And as you are trapped here, we have Mars looking at that situation and saying, no, Sagittarius, you will not be trapped anyway. Not my Sagittarius is no. And Mars here with his shield and his bow and arrow, with his might, with his force, with his fire and drive. You are a fire sign, Sagittarius. So Mars is here lending you that fire, that drive to free yourself from this situation. So, Sagittarius, here is a remedy for you. If you're feeling really stuck, if you're feeling really lost, if you're just feeling a bit depressed and just gloomy, the divine wants you to know, when you're feeling like that and you catch yourself in that feeling, just close your eyes and call on Mars, the warrior god, to come and help you, to assist you through this battle, this mind-filled battle that you are going through. Ask Mars, focus on Mars. Even if you just get the planet Mars on your phone and look at that picture and try and magnetize that energy to you, to give you that passion and that drive and that warrior-like energy to free yourself. Because when you have finally have had enough of this situation, you are going to stand up, Sagittarius, and you are going to take that bow and arrow of yours. You're going to put fire on it, and you are going to blast yourself out of your mind and free yourself from this imprisonment that you don't belong in. Sagittarius, this is the reading that I have for you. Don't forget to share this reading with your friends, your family, who might be going through similar type of energies. And to be honest, this is not just your energy. Anyone else who's going through this type of energy, Sagittarius, share this video with them so that they can get inspired, so that they can get their power back, so that they can free themselves too. So give this video a thumbs up, comment, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. On that note, I'm going to see you in my next video, and it's a goodbye from me. Bye.